Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. On Monday the 18th of May there was a new update release for Capture 120. It's a free update for existing users and today I'll be looking at a few of the improvements. I'll start by saying that as a Fuji shooter I'm actually a big fan of Capture One. I made the switch to using Capture One for my Fuji RAW processing around 12 months ago and I've been extremely pleased with the results. Despite this, there's a few things I don't like about the software, and this release is supposed to address a couple of these. If you check the Capture One website, which incidentally is new, you'll find a new feature list. The ones that I'm particularly interested to see are the heel and clone brushes, as well as the before and after preview. I've always found the cloning and healing confusing in Capture One. Until now, you needed to use the mask brush and apply it onto either a heel or a clone layer to make repairs. In the new release, you have individual heel and clone brushes. To try these, I'll use this image of a railway viaduct and remove some of the ivy from one of the supports. The first thing to notice is that we now have separate heel and clone tools in the layers panel. When I pick one of these brushes, let's say the heel brush, and I start to paint, it creates a new heel layer. Using the heel brush, Capture One automatically makes a sample for the repair. In this example, it's actually made quite a good job of selecting and repairing the image, but it doesn't always do such a good job, especially with more complex selections. You can change the automatic sampling though by clicking and selecting the sample point. Now I can drag to move it to a better position. Another new feature is being able to nudge the sample into position using the arrow keys on my keyboard. These allow me to make extremely fine corrections to the repair. If you want to adjust the heel and clone brush settings, you can right click with that tool enabled, just as you can with the brush tool. Then you can adjust the settings and when you move the mouse pointer off the window, it vanishes. Whilst I like this, I would like to see them add the ability to adjust the brush settings to an existing repair. It's easy to forget to make a brush change before you start a repair. Now let's look at the clone brush. If I try to paint over an area as a first step, Capture One complains I haven't set the sample source. You can do this by holding down the Option key or the Alt key on a PC and then clicking on a point to sample. After that, I can then paint over the area I want to clone out. You'll also see this feature creates a new clone layer if there wasn't one already in the image. Then when I select either the clone brush or the healing brush, Capture One will automatically select the relevant layer for the repair. But if I'm working on a complicated image with lots of repairs, I often create multiple separate layers. I can do this though by manually adding a new layer, just as I would have in an earlier version. If I have multiple layers of the same type, the automatic selection then chooses the newest layer. Now let's go back and take a better look at the healing brush because I want to show you a few things that aren't immediately obvious. The first is how to delete a repair. Before you can delete a single repair, you need to first select it by clicking the sample point. You can then delete it by pressing the delete or backspace key on your keyboard. The next point is that we have the clone and heal brushes now in the main toolbar. You'll find these grouped together with the spot removal tool. Like a lot of these tools, you need to click and hold with your mouse button to expand the menu. If you right click, you see a different set of options to customize the toolbar. As I've mentioned already, when using the heel brush, Capture One automatically creates a sample area to use for the repair. Now whilst I like this, sometimes I know it's not going to make a good repair and I want to use a specific sample. Fortunately, I can do this by holding down the Option key or Alt key on a PC. This allows me to fix the sample point just as I would have with the clone brush. Whilst I do like the new brushes, I'm still finding my feet and some of the behaviour I'm finding is a bit confusing. For example, I could have an active sample point because I've been moving it around. If I then paint to repair other areas, all the repairs seem to be linked to that point. When I move the sample point around, you can see that it's now repositioning all of the repairs. Sometimes the software seems to go wrong after I've done this. If I deselect the point and try to create another repair, sometimes it seems to mix them up and I can't see where the sample's being taken from. Now this could be my not understanding the behaviour, because the next feature also had me a little confused. If I make a repair near to an existing repair, the software doesn't create a new sample, but it actually extends the existing repair. Despite this, even with my lack of familiarity, I'm finding the repairs are quite good. The other improvement in this release that I want to talk about is the before and after comparison. You can activate this using this new icon in the toolbar. When I click and hold the icon, you can see that there are two options. In the full screen mode, what you see is the starting image when you click the icon. When I click the icon a second time, it turns this off and you see the image with the edits. The other option is the split screen view, where the left half of the image shows the original and the right half shows the edits. I can then click and drag to reposition that split. As well as using the icon in the toolbar, I can use a couple of shortcut keys which are useful to remember. When I press the Y key on my keyboard, I can toggle the full screen preview on and off. If I want to toggle the split screen preview on and off, I can use the Shift and Y key. This seems like a simple change, but it's something that I've really missed when working with Capture One, so it's great to see that. So that's the three new options that I wanted to cover in this video, explaining version 13.1 of Capture One 20. I hope you found this helpful. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you next week for another video.